6:02 right now. Senator Mazie Hirono visited the controversial child detention facilities at the U.S.-Mexico border this weekend. On Twitter, she described them as internment camps. She joins us now by phone to discuss the trip. Good morning, Senator.
Good morning.
Morning. So first of all, take us through the experience. What did you see and what did you hear? What did you gather?
Well, for one thing, I think it starts with the entire Trump administration's attitude toward immigrants or people who are coming across the border seeking asylum. They want to make it as hard as possible. So we went to two family facilities in San Antonio. These are where parents and their children are placed. And then as far as I'm concerned, totally unacceptable. We went to El Paso where we visited Tornillo, which is basically a tent city that was set up just to house unaccompanied children. And the facility in Tornillo was put up to be a 30-day facility for taking care of the children who were separated parents under the initial Trump zero tolerance policy. So this was supposed to last for only 30 days. That was about in June, and here we are in December. So there are about 2,700 children there. Most of them already have sponsors, but it's taking a long time to have the children and the sponsors come together. Why? Yet another Trump administration policy that says all of the sponsors for these children have to be fingerprinted, including everybody in the extended family. What this does is create a very chilling effect because many of the sponsors are undocumented, but they can take care of these undocumented children. But why should they come forward and have this information shared with ICE, which is what's happening under this new requirement, wherein the sponsors can be deported? So all across the board, what's happening is people are being detained in facilities that should not be the first thing that we do. There are options. There are alternatives to keeping children for extended periods of time and for keeping families from being able to do what they need to do in order to seek asylum protection.
Senator, from what I've read, you weren't given much time to talk or interact with the children. But
well, we were prohibited,
right.
Actually.
Oh, okay.
It's not a time issue. We were told that we could not speak with the children, and when I asked why, it was explained that we would interrupt their schedules. And I said, if you were to tell these young people, and this was when we were in Tornillo, where it's all these unaccompanied children, that if these children were told that there are people who care about them, who want to help them, perhaps they would voluntarily want to speak with us. So it's a facility that, regardless of whether their physical needs are being met, we know from mental health experts that the longer you keep children in this kind of a situation, the more emotional and mental problems that they will have, and often for the rest of their lives. So family separation among immigrants is a very damaging policy to follow, but that's exactly what Trump is doing because he really wants to stop immigration to our country from places that he calls asshole countries.
Yeah. So, Senator, we've seen reports from the past saying that similar circumstances were happening under the Obama administration. In your eyes and from what you've seen, how does this differ from that?
They love to say that, well, somebody else did it, because for one thing, this administration refuses to take responsibility for the harm that it does. There was never a zero tolerance policy in the Obama administration that ripped children from the arms of their parents, but that's what this administration did, that's what this president did, and that is why Tornillo was set up very hastily to house all of the thousands of children who were suddenly unaccompanied minors, even if they came to this country with parents. So this is an administration that refuses to take responsibility for what they're doing. They're always pointing their fingers at other people. Well, this is one of the reasons that there are those of us who want to see for ourselves what's going on and to tell the public the truth.
Yeah, Senator Hirono joining us with her experience from visiting these detention centers. Thank you, Senator, for your time this morning.